In the early afternoon on August 30th, a Smartlynx Malta Airbus A321 was on approach to Yash after a two-hour flight from Milan Bergamo, when the crew reported an issue with their navigation system. The crew performed an instrument approach to runway 14, but initiated a missed approach as they were too high. The crew repositioned for a visual approach to the same runway, landing safely and without intervention from the ready emergency services. The aircraft remained on the ground overnight and departed at 0600 local time the following morning, bound for Billund. Just after 0900 local time on Tuesday, August 31st, a GOL Boeing 737-800 took off from runway 20 left at Santos Dumont Airport, the second major airport serving Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Upon rotation, the tail of the aircraft made contact with the runway surface. The crew continued the takeoff and climbed to flight level 120, where they entered a hold at Arsov to assess the situation. The crew elected to continue to Sao Paulo, Congonhas, where they landed safely after approximately 55 minutes in the air. At 1,323 meters long, the runway at Santos Dumont demands high performance from the 737, being one of the shortest runways regularly operated by the type. In 2004, in response to GOL's needs at Santos Dumont, Boeing developed the Short Field Performance, or SFP, enhancement package, which adds a two-position tail skid that enables reduced approach speeds, sealed leading edge slats that provide increased lift during takeoff, and increased flight spoiler deflection on the ground that improves takeoff and landing performance. The modifications enable weight increases of approximately 4,700 kilograms for landing and 1,700 kilograms for takeoff from short runways. On the night of Friday, September 3rd, a Rossiya Sukhoi Superjet 100 operating a flight on behalf of Aeroflot departed from Moscow Sheremetyevo. Shortly after takeoff, the crew reported problems with the aircraft's control systems. The aircraft had fallen back to minimum mode, where the autopilot and other automated flight control functionality is unavailable. The crew declared an emergency and assumed manual control of the aircraft, returning to the airport and landing safely about 25 minutes after departing.